Now that we are connected on the aquarium instance, this is what the H2O Driverless AI landing page should look like. If you wish, you can follow along, but I would recommend paying attention to my presentation first and then solve the assignments, which you will find at the end of the lecture. They are specially designed for you to get a lot of quality practice out of this class. For those connecting for the first time on the Driverless AI platform, there are no data sets available. You need to import them yourselves, and this is what we are going to do in the next module. But for now, let's just explore the user interface together. On the top left side of the screen, you can see what the driverless AI version number I am using. So, depending on when you are going to take the training or what the connection settings of your company are, this might change. Nevertheless, please rest assured that the majority of the changes do not affect the main functionalities that we are going to use in this class. On the top right side of the screen, there are a couple of tabs. When connecting to the Driverless AI platform, the default landing page is the Datasets tab. This is the place where you are going to find all your stored datasets. On the top of the screen, you can also see a Projects tab, which is the place where you can organize your work, gather all your experiments for a particular use case in just one place, compare the experiments, or collaborate with peers, just to give a couple of examples. In the datasets section, you can view all your datasets that you uploaded or added to the driverless AI platform. Next up, there is an AutoVis tab where you can automatically generate visualizations based on your chosen dataset and its various feature types. In the Experiments tab, you can find all your experiments and all the information that you need with respect to the trained models. This is the place where we are going to spend the most part of our time, as from this page, we can do a lot of interesting things, such as creating new experiments, training models, creating recipes, viewing the results, and many more. In the Diagnostics tab, you can get even more insights from your models and experiments. Here, you can learn additional information about the dataset, and you can also download predictions, view interactive metric plots, and get scores about particular experiments. In the Machine Learning Interpretability view, or the MLI tab, Driverless AI employs a host of different techniques and methodologies for interpreting and explaining the results of its models. This is an entire topic in itself and will be treated thoroughly in another learning path. The Recipes tab gives you the possibility to add and manage your own custom recipes, which are Python code snippets that can be uploaded into Driverless AI at runtime, like plugins. The Deployments tab is the place where you can manage all your deployments. This is also a subject that will be covered separately in another lesson. Next up, the Resources tab, which contains the Driverless AI documentation, as well as additional information about the system that was used for running the experiment. If you do not want to use the Driverless AI user interface too much, there are also R and Python clients, which give you the possibility to code yourself if you wish. And lastly, from the User tab, you can log out, but you can also have access to the user settings and all the available notifications of the platform.